Hi, Jim Beckler with the RV Corral. Welcome to our website. Thanks for taking the time to take a look at one of our motorhomes we have for sale here. This is a really nice 2017 Sunseeker built by Forest River, and it's got a right nice floor plan. So we get inside, you can take a look and see it's for a 24-foot motorhome. It's got a lot of room. Now my number, by the way, is 541-510-1017. In case you need to get a hold of me, you can call me directly at that number. Again, it's Jim Beckler, so give me a shout if you have questions or anything I can do to help. But for starters, on this motorhome, I want to tell you too about a few things I think that stand out. One is, of course, it does have, you can see it has a nice full body paint. The finish is much nicer when you have a full body paint coach. This stays looking good for a longer period of time. I'm sure you've probably seen motorhomes that have decals instead of paint, and over a period of time, if they're exposed to the weather, they start fading or maybe peeling or checking. You know, they just don't look the same after a few years. So with full body paint, you're protecting the outside, adds to the resale value, you know, looks good for a longer period of time. In addition to that, on this particular motorhome, it has a one-piece fiberglass roof also. So that's also an advantage over a rubber roof because it's more durable, it's going to stay, be less maintenance, and it stays looking better over a longer period of time. Not that you're going to be up on the roof taking a look to see what it looks like just for fun, but the idea is you want as little maintenance as possible on a motorhome, which kind of makes sense. This is built on the Mercedes-Benz Sprinter chassis, so it has the six-cylinder diesel Mercedes, turbo power, good performance, drives very nice, has some really nice driving features. I think you really like the way this drives. Easy access getting into the cab. It's got the nice step that makes it easier to get in and out. Nice thing about this coach too, it does have doors on both sides so you can get in and out. In the front part of the cab as well as your main entry door here. As you look down the side of the coach, you can see it does have a nice full-size awning, good-size patio awning. This is typically the area where you're going to be hanging out and having the fun. This side of the coach is the fun side. The other side is kind of the work side where you got your hookups and all that stuff. So the awning comes out quite a ways. It's electric, so it's just push-button operation, very easy to go in and out. I like the fact it's got a nice handle to help you get in and out too. Bays, compartments on the side here, you got a nice access to your propane, got a nice size propane tank, a little storage compartment right there. Notice it's a rotocast, so it's a hard plastic material that they make that out of, so it's lighter weight and it's also easier to clean, keep clean. So we go around the back. So you do have a ladder to get up on top. Backup monitor on this one. It also has side view cameras. As I mentioned, this is kind of the work side. You can see you have more storage compartments over here too. So there are a lot of different compartments for storage. Before we look in some of those, let me note too that it does have the frameless windows. You may have already noticed that. That's really a nice look. They fit a little more flush to the side of the coach. Gives it a nice sharp appeal. Outside shower. This is a little access panel here. It looks like it's being stubborn. There we go. Little place where you can stash your sewer hose. There's your power outlet hookup there. Most of your outlets or hookups are over on this side. Even has a little sprayer in here. You needed to pressure wash something, spray it down. Maybe you had gotten the sand or the mud and you wanted to hose down. This one comes with a little Dyson vacuum cleaner too. So it has its own vacuum. It's with a charger right there so you can plug in and charge up. Here's your power cord. Nice 30 amp power cord. It's equipped with a nice 3600 LP generator. So you got a nice quiet on-end generator. So if you do dry camp a lot, you'll like having that. Hook the sewer hookups, easy to get to. You mentioned a little Yeah, storage compartments all over here on this side of the coach especially. Lots of places to put all your stuff, head out on the road. And then down here you actually have a couple more. There's a nice large compartment, as well as one over here. See, as you look on this side, this one does have one large slide out, almost a full wall slide. You'll see when we get inside how much that adds to the livability of this floor plan. Again, this is a 2400W floor plan, very good floor plan, one of the newer ones that they've come out with. Let's take a look inside. But before we go in, there's one other thing I guess I should mention. Does have, it's wired already for solar, so if you dry camp a lot and you wanted to pick up one of those portable solar panels, you can just plug it in right here. It'll keep your house batteries charged up while you're out camping. You can just move that little solar panel around and pick up some sunlight and keep those batteries charged. Nice easy step getting in. This particular model does have a bed up front here also, so you do have the ability to sleep quite a few people. This slips over, makes into a nice bed. TV swivels out, you got your front TV there, moves out this direction so you can see it from the main part of the cab. I like the fact it's got power outlet up here also, a couple cup holders and some compartments there for storage. You can put some things up in there, whoever's sleeping up there could keep their stash of candy bars or snacks or whatever it is you like to have with you when you're up in your loft area. I mentioned it does have a backup camera. It also has side view cameras too. So this monitor here will up here will display your back and the sides of the coach. So if you needed to see what was happening on one of the sides of the motorhome, you can also pick that up on that monitor. In fact, whenever you turn your turn signal on, if you're going down the highway, you put your turn signal on. If you're going to change lanes, it'll display that side of the coach so you can see what's happening over there. Really helps eliminate blind spots. Some really nice safety features on this. Again, it's a Mercedes chassis. Mercedes has always been a leader in the industry in safety. So this motorhome has actual yaw sensors designed into it, so it has computer sensors that will determine driver intent. So in other words, if you going too fast around a corner and you start to slide a little bit, those computer sensors note that, and by the time you figured out you were in a little bit of trouble, it's already making corrections to help bring you back in to your intended path. So it'll use brake to the wheels, because you have four-wheel anti-lock brakes. And it also will use power to the wheels to help correct you. So again, by the time you figured out that maybe you, going around a little too fast here, it's already starting to make corrections. Notice the front seats do swivel around too, which makes it nice. Both these seats are gonna come around. Has a little table that comes with this one too, so you can, great place to maybe sit in the morning and have your coffee, or if you have guests over maybe for cocktails or something along those lines. You've got seating up here too, so quite a bit of seating in this one. Nice big dinette booth. The table comes out. This actually will drop down, and so you have another bed that you can make here as well. Notice the nice big storage compartments. This one comes with a portable barbecue too, which we'll see here in just a second. But notice how deep these drawers are. Metal glides, so they're really nice and heavy duty. You can put some weight in, you don't have to worry about those glides falling out. Also has a charging station over here. You have power, so you have 110 power, but if you do want to charge up an apparatus, you've got the ability to do that right there. Kitchen area has got a nice layout, three burner cook stove with a cover, So this makes it nice so you can actually use this as workspace if you weren't cooking on it. Again, more drawer space, great place to put pots and pans. Storage underneath the sink. Has a nice little residential style faucet with a sprayer. Nice deep stainless steel sink. Pretty much all the comforts of home. More storage up above. Now this unit does have a convection microwave, so you have an oven here as well as a microwave, so it'll do both. Once you get the hang of that, they really work well. People really like those that have them. You even have a little bit of countertop extension on this one. Your DVD player is already set up here. This is your home entertainment. DVD, CD, going to do it all for you right there. You can have a little compartment in here too where you could throw some, maybe some of your favorite movies in case you get out there and the weather's not too good. You want to hang out in here and watch a movie instead of being out in the cold weather, which if you camp in Oregon, you've probably been there before. I didn't mention when we came in the door, but while we're right here, let me just show you a couple things here also. It has a battery disconnect switch here, so if I put it in the off position, it's going to turn off my lighting in here. So if I'm storing the coach, I can put it in the off position when I come in and I want to have lights, so I have access to my house batteries. I can just turn this into the on position. You have controls right here too, so they're, it's nice to have them right next to the door. So you like your awning controls right here. I can move that awning in and out from right here. This has electric stabilizers on the back, which controlled right here, and lighting. You have a switch here for the step, and even has a little awning light out there, so it makes it really nice when your awning's out. You have light in there too. So getting back to the kitchen, I guess we didn't really finish that, but here you have a nice two-door refrigerator with a freezer on top, refrigerator down below, separate controls up here, which are really nice. They call it a convenience center because it is handy. It's all in one area. You can check all your tank levels from here, start your generator, turn on your water heater, water pump, all that. You have access right here, lighting controls for your slide out, in and out right here. I like the fact this one has the Arctic pack too. You know, I mentioned in Oregon you could be out camped in some of the higher elevations even in the better time of the year and you could get some cold weather all of a sudden. Having this Arctic pack is nice because with just a flick of a switch you can turn that on and it'll give heat to your holding tank, so it helps keep you from getting into a little trouble maybe if your holding tanks got too cold and you have them freeze up or you got water lines that are freezing up on you. So turn on the Arctic pack in case you do get in some cold weather. It's going to help you keep protected that way. Bathroom has a nice stand-up shower, toilet all in one, sink. There's a good sized skylight to let in some natural light. Got storage in here too. And has a little good sized medicine cabinet. Put a little towel rack in there for you. This unit's equipped with a nice size shelf here for adjustable shelves actually, so you could use this as a pantry. Does have hook holders up top too, so if you wanted to pull these out, maybe put something in there that you wanted to hang, you can do that. This one also works as a closet, additional storage. Notice the cedar wood on the back panel. Really nice quality units, put together well. Forest River is a good manufacturer. We carry quite a few of their product lines actually. We like the fact that part of Berkshire Hathaway, which is, you know, to us that means a lot because as a dealership, we like to carry product lines that are financially solvent. And so since Berkshire Hathaway's part of Warren Buffett's empire, we figure that he's probably got enough money to keep this thing going. Notice the nice walk-around bed in the back here. This really makes it nice. A lot of smaller coaches, you don't have a walk-around bed, but the way they've designed this one, you do have the bed that you can access from both sides. This coach just came in, so we don't have the bedding out yet, but you can see it's all still in the wrapper. You're getting a chance to see one the way we see them when they come from the factory. Obviously, all this stuff's going to be set up, and these get cleaned, and we go through everything before you actually take the motorhome out of here. So we're just getting a chance to see, look at one the way it is when we get them in here. It does have a TV in the back, and your barbecue has its own stand. Like I said, this one will plug into the outside too. You have a quick connection. You can just plug in your barbecue out there. Yeah, maybe you have a motorhome now. You've got a bigger coach. Maybe you're in a Class A. You're thinking, nah, I still want an RV, but maybe not. I don't want as big a motorhome. This would be a great motorhome to consider downsizing to. A lot of people do that. We see that happen a lot. You know, with that Mercedes diesel, people get good mileage with these. That's another benefit with that chassis. So good drivability, good economy, a lot of safety features. This is a wonderful coach, good floor plan. Love to tell you a little bit more about it or show it to you up close and personal. Again, you can reach me at 541-510-1017. So please ask for me. Again, it's Jim Beckler, and I'll be glad to help.